Hello everyone, welcome to today's Lectio Divina. In this reading today, we're going to read from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 12, verse 39 to 48. Now, the way this is going to work is I'm going to read the Gospel, I'm going to invite you to do a meditation upon it, and then I'm just going to keep this video really short, so that way, maybe if you're using these series just to start your day, you can have something to think about, and then without too much commentary from me. So. This comes from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus said to his disciples, "Be sure of this. If the master of the house had known the hour when the thief was coming, he would not have let his house be broken into. You must also be prepared, for at an hour you do not expect, the Son of Man will come." Then Peter said, "Lord, is this parable meant for us or for everyone?" And the Lord replied, "Who then is the faithful and prudent steward whom the master will put in charge of his servants to distribute the food allowance at the proper time? Blessed is that servant whom his master on arrival finds doing so. Truly I say to you, he will put him in charge of all his property. But if that servant says to himself, 'My master is delayed in coming,' and begins to beat the men servants and maid servants, to eat and drink and get drunk, then that servant's master will come at an unexpected day, at an unknown hour, and will punish the servant severely and assign him a place with the unfaithful. That servant who knew his master's will, but did not make preparations nor act according with his will, shall be beaten severely. And the servant who is ignorant of his master's will, but acted in a way deserving of a severe beating, shall be beaten only lightly. Much will be required of the person entrusted with much, and still more will be demanded of the person entrusted with more." That concludes the gospel today. Now the phrase I invite you to focus on, and of course you're always welcome to focus on any other phrase, but the one that stuck out to me the most was the final verse, which was, "Much will be required of the persons entrusted with much, and still more will be demanded of the person entrusted with more." In other translations it would say, "To whom much is given, much is expected," right? And I think a good thing to meditate upon today and to think about is how much God has entrusted you. Right? What knowledge has he given you? Especially if you're a baptized Catholic, you got the sacraments, you have the magisterium, you have the papacy, you have the saints, you have a lot of things at your disposal, a lot of resources to help you know and understand your faith better. And you know, one of the things that we have to be mindful of as Catholics is that the path to heaven isn't like getting on a train ride and getting like a first class train ride to heaven, and then everyone else is sitting in like the back, right? I think Taylor Marshall explained it like an airplane, right? It's the same kind of analogy, right? As Catholics, we're not privileged, but we are in a way given more, you know, more resources at our disposal. So that being said, you know, if there's someone who's not a Catholic and they are living according to the teaching of the church, maybe unknowingly, then, you know, that's great. But the thing is, though, the sacraments are something that we as Catholics have. And the worst part about it, not the worst part, but kind of the thing to be aware of is that because you know so much, because you were raised Catholic, if you were raised Catholic and you were catechized in the faith and you honestly had good catechesis and you decide to leave, then you're going to be very culpable for that. And I think that's something that we have to be aware of, especially as Catholics, is that, you know, we are given a lot. Really, we are given a lot. And in the church, and it's a wonderful thing. And this is why it's our duty to try to that all men are just saved, you know, by believing in Jesus Christ alone. Like, you got to actually work for it. And you got to look at the Epistle of James. Like, you'll see, like, works come in hand. And don't misunderstand me. I'm not saying that we are saved by our own works, but we are saved through faith and through the grace of Jesus Christ, who gives us the ability to perform those works, right? Any good work you do isn't just from you. It's coming from God, and God is working through you. And that's what we mean by doing good works, is we're doing the will of God. So yeah, something to think about today. And also another thing too is that you never know when your time is going to be up. I think I kind of discussed this the other day. You never know when Jesus will come back. It could be at the end of time. It could be at your own death. And we know both are certain, right? We know for sure death is going to happen. So we know that our Lord is going to come to us at the particular judgment, and then he'll come again at the final judgment. And I think a lot of us focus a lot on the final judgment because it's kind of apocalyptic and sounds really fun. But, you know, the particular judgment is much closer, I would say. Much closer. Again, the end of the world can happen today. It can happen within the next minute. But the end of the world for you, right, the end of your soul, is going to happen much sooner than the end of the world, at least in my opinion. That's why I think it's going to happen. So, hope you guys are gracious for today. God bless.